Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. Experiments can be dangerous. If you are a child, never do experiments unless your parent, guardian, or adult educator says it's all right and is there with you the whole time. If you've not already done so, we suggest that you watch the video about forces before watching this video. Which of these images shows unbalanced forces, and what are the names for those forces? To answer those questions, we'll learn about balanced forces, unbalanced forces, and common forces. A lot of engineering and using technology is based on understanding balanced versus unbalanced forces. In this video, we'll define the terms body, rest, speed, velocity, force, balanced forces, and unbalanced forces. We'll show how to identify when there are balanced versus unbalanced forces acting on a body. And we'll name some common forces and show how they act on bodies to make balanced and unbalanced forces. First, let's define seven terms. In our everyday use, we use words like body, balance, and rest. In physics, we also use these words, but we have different definitions for them. In physics, the word body can mean any person, animal, or object. A body can be any size, from a tiny grain of sand to an entire planet. In physics, when we say the phrase a body is at rest, we mean that the body is staying in the same place. For example, even though all of these people are very active and parts of their bodies are in motion, we consider all of them to be at rest. The reason is because each one is staying in the same location. In physics, when we refer to a body's speed, we are talking about how fast the entire body is moving its location. For example, these geese are flying at 35 miles per hour. The word velocity means two things. It refers to both the speed and the direction that a body is moving its location. For example, this body is going west at 35 miles an hour. This body is going up at 15 feet per minute. These bodies are going down at 10 feet per minute. A body at rest has a velocity too, though that value is zero. If a body's speed and direction are staying the same, we say it has constant velocity. If a body's speed or direction are changing, we say it has a changing velocity. Let's pause for a quick quiz. For the next eight images, please state whether each is an example of constant velocity or changing velocity. These bicycles are going at 20 miles per hour, but their direction is changing, so their velocity is changing. This seal is going 0 miles per hour, so its velocity is constant. This lady is going in a straight line, but her speed is increasing, so her velocity is changing. This jet ski is going 15 miles per hour, but its direction is changing, so its velocity is changing. These boats and ships are going 0 miles per hour, so their velocity is constant. This kite surfer is going at 10 miles an hour, but his direction is changing, so his velocity is changing. This girl is walking in a straight line at a steady speed, so her velocity is constant. And this cheetah is going in a straight line, but its speed is slowing down, so its velocity is changing. Now we'll resume our definitions. A force is something that, if unopposed, can change a body's velocity. Similar to velocity, forces have both an amount and a direction. For example, this man is pulling up on this dumbbell with a force of 25 pounds. This tractor is pulling east on this trailer with a force of 10,000 pounds. And this bulldozer is pushing west on this dirt with a force of 50,000 pounds. The source of the force could be outside the body, such as in the case of this rope. Or the body may be the source for one or more forces, such as in the case of this climber who is using forces in her arms and legs to move her body upwards against the force of gravity. In physics, the term balanced forces means when two or more forces are in an equal amount, but going in different directions. For example, when this scale is balanced, there will be equal weights in each pan, and those pans then create downward forces that are equal in size, but are trying to rotate the beam in opposite directions. One is trying to rotate it clockwise and one is trying to rotate it counterclockwise. Similarly, the term unbalanced forces also means when two or more forces are going in different directions. But in unbalanced forces, the sizes of the opposing forces are unequal. Now we're ready to identify if there are balanced or unbalanced forces acting on a body. Here are the two rules. If a body's velocity is constant, then there are balanced forces acting on the body. If the velocity is changing, Then there are unbalanced forces acting on the body. Let's pause for a quick quiz. Please classify each of the following four images as being due to balanced forces or unbalanced forces. These bodies are at rest, so their velocity is constant. That means there are balanced forces acting on them. These bodies are changing their direction and speed very frequently, so their velocities are changing. That means there are unbalanced forces acting on them. These bodies have a consistent direction, but are changing their speed, so their velocities are changing. That means there are unbalanced forces acting on them. And this body has a consistent speed and direction, so its velocity is constant. That means there are balanced forces acting on it. Our final topic is to name the forces that affect a body's velocity. We'll look at three common cases. The first case we'll look at is what balanced forces make a body's constant velocity equal zero. During this tug of war, the body, which is the rope, moves towards the bigger dog when its pulling force is greatest, or the body moves towards the smaller dog when its pulling force is greatest. But when each dog's pulling force is in equal in amount and opposite direction to each other, we say there are balanced forces acting on the rope. When that happens, the rope has a constant velocity that equals zero. Then the rope is a body at rest. We'll use this same idea when analyzing forces in the vertical direction. This man's vertical velocity is constant, so there are balanced forces acting on him in the vertical direction. Gravity is pulling down his body with a force of 150 pounds. That downward force is balanced by 150 pounds of upward pulling force from the rope. Likewise, all of these people have a constant vertical velocity, so there are balanced vertical forces acting on them. Since each person's weight is different, the values of the downward force and balancing upward forces are unique. This man is standing on a beach. He weighs 150 pounds. Since his vertical velocity is constant, that means there are balanced forces acting on him. The ground is causing the upward force, and it is pushing up with 150 pounds of force. Although it seems strange to say that the ground is pushing up with a force that equals the person's weight, this is true when our feet stay on the surface of the ground. If the ground is not able to push up with a force equal to our weight, then instead of being still when we step on the ground surface, our feet would keep moving past the surface, and we would sink until we reached ground that is strong enough to push up on our weight with an equal force. Likewise, since this body's velocity is constant, we know there are balanced forces acting on it. Gravity pulls down with 2 pounds of force, and the bridge is pushing up with 2 pounds of force. If the bridge was able to push up with only 1 pound of force, then there would be unbalanced forces on the body. Next, we'll look at balanced forces acting on a body with a velocity greater than zero. This boat is going 30 miles per hour. Its engines are pushing the boat forwards with a force of 5,000 pounds. Since the boat's velocity is constant, we know there are balanced forces acting on it, which means there must be 5,000 pounds of force pushing in the direction opposite to the force of the motors. A major part of that 5,000 pounds of opposing force is the weight of the water that the boat pushes out of the way. With slow-moving vessels, we can see some of this water as a bow wave. Just like a boat has to push water out of the way so it can pass, land vehicles must push air out of the way so they can pass. Instead of saying the phrase, push air out of the way, we say air resistance. Air resistance feels like wind, except it's what we make when we move through the air. It can blow our hats off and blow our hair back. To move a lot of air takes a huge amount of effort. Air resistance is a large force that an engine must push against to keep a car's velocity constant. The other big opposing force on land vehicles is friction. Here's a close-up of a bicycle wheel rubbing against the axle. Friction is always trying to slow things down and acts where two objects rub against each other. Likewise, a moving train wheel generates huge amounts of friction that creates a force opposing the engine. Just to keep the train's velocity constant, the engine must keep making a large forward force to balance the opposing forces made by friction and air resistance. Next, let's look at unbalanced forces that can change a body's velocity. When this man jumps off a cliff, his velocity changes every second. That tells us there are unbalanced forces acting on his body. There is a 135-pound downward force due to gravity, but only 4 pounds of upward force due to air resistance. But if he had jumped from a higher level, then there would have been more time that his body was acted on by unbalanced forces. That means his velocity would have increased up to 120 miles per hour. With a downward velocity of 120 miles per hour, the upward force of air resistance gets much larger and becomes equal to the downward force of gravity on the falling body. That means gravity and air resistance are now balanced forces acting on the body, so its velocity becomes constant. That means these skydivers will not speed up anymore, even without using their parachutes, and even if they fall for thousands of additional feet. When the skydivers deploy their parachutes, the very large upward air resistance force makes an unbalanced force on their bodies, so their velocities change again. With a lower velocity, the parachute generates less upward air resistance force, and when that force becomes equal to the downward force of gravity, the body is once again acted on by balanced forces. That means the body's velocity becomes constant, but this time it's only 15 miles per hour. And with mild adjustments, the skydiver can adjust the vertical velocity even further just prior to landing. Here's a summary of the topic we just covered. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. Thanks for your attention.